Now we're just 3 days out from the first of two long-awaited heavyweight bouts.
AJ Anthony Joshua.
This fight is my everything, my soul, my spirit, my mind, my body. Right now, I'm not thinking about any championship belts.
I'm just a beginner out here that's going to come as an underdog to win the fight.
Ngannou's no mug. Got to be careful against this guy. You know, you can't just rush in because he's going to throw with you.
This is AJ's hardest fight of all his fights. It's the unknown.
Big right hand down from Joshua. And down goes Selenius. Victor Lachlan waves his arms. And the fight is over.
Oh! Fury's down. Fury is down.
Oh my God.
Losing against Ngannou, it would be a big step back and possibly the end of his career, really.
I heard that he doesn't have a chin. I don't know if it's true or not. I hope I had an opportunity to test that out.
You have to take someone's soul, you have to take their spirit. And I'm looking forward to the challenge for sure. I just want to conquer and make everyone know that I'm the one who puts boxing on the map.
So this Friday, it's AJ against Francis Ngannou in Saudi. The TalkSport and TalkSport Boxing YouTube channels will be offering an unmissable live and free watch-along with Adam Cattrall, Spencer Oliver and Carl Froch from 9 o'clock. Joining us now to tell you more and build up the fight, former European super bantamweight champion Spencer Oliver. Morning, Spencer.
Morning, Spencer. How are you?
Jeff, Ali, how are you both doing?
We're in short form. Spencer, this story is remarkable. I'm just looking at Francis Ngannou, and what was it, 5-6 months ago, UFC champion. You can rightly or wrongly say very unlucky not to beat Tyson Fury. And that in itself would tell you he's got to go down as a really, really dangerous opponent for AJ.
Ali, exactly that, mate. You know, forget the fact that, you know, he enters this fight as with a boxing record of 0-1. That's one fight, yeah. One loss. We all saw the fight with Tyson Fury. You know, I was quite vocal about it. I thought he won the fight. He had Fury down in the third round. Fury badly hurt. And I think what he showed us there was, you know, that he's got that adaptability. He could go in there. And he was the one that was changing things up. And he was the one that had Tyson Fury thinking as opposed to the other way around. So he come out with a lot of credibility. You know, whether the fight went his way or didn't go his way, what he done was he pushed the WBC champ to the wire, had him on the seat of his pants. And, you know, he comes into this fight as a very dangerous, dangerous opponent for Anthony Joshua. You can't not say that. You know, I think what Ngannou does is he throws punches when his opponent's throwing. He switches from orthodox to southpaw. He loves to draw a guy in. He's very strong. He's got a great big thick neck, a big head like a medicine ball, really. And he just soaks up the punches. So it's a tough fight for AJ. It really is.
I saw this week, Spencer, that AJ had vowed to make a statement on Friday. Now, is that sort of confidence being reflected in what you're seeing of him at the moment?
Yes, Jeff. I think what it is with Anthony Joshua is that he didn't have the confidence in his own ability because he was not getting, he wasn't boxing regularly enough, you know. And I think that we look now, and this is his fourth fight in 11 months. And you look at the last fight against Otto Wallin, you know, in those first three fights, we saw Jermaine Franklin, Robert Hellenius, and then the last one, like I just said there, against Otto Wallin. You look at those performances and you saw the improvement in every single one. And that was the Joshua improving in his confidence, you know, having the confidence to stay there, let his shots go in combinations, then go again, because that's what took Joshua to the top of the heavyweight division. You know, that boxing, that rawness, that boxing with his heart on his sleeve. And I think we saw that with the Otto Wallin fight in the last performance. And he's buzzing now that he's boxing so regularly. But what he's got to do is not, you know, he can't be greedy in this one. He can't sit in the pocket too long. He can't get carried away with throwing punches because he has to think about the shots that are coming back to him. Because as we saw, Ngannou, he's heavy-handed. So it's high risk, but he also does get the rewards. You know, there's a lot of talk about high risk, low reward for Anthony Joshua. What does he get out of it? Well, he gets the winner of Alexander Usyk versus Tyson Fury, the fight that's happening on May the 18th. That's what he gets out of it. And he wants to be known as the best of this generation. So he has to go through this fight. But I've got to tell you, boys, it's a dangerous one.
Spencer, he's obviously lost a couple of times, excuse me, to Alexander Usyk. And to be honest, I just think he looks a different level, right? So he's come back, a good performance, you're right, 5 rounds in December there against Otto Wallin. This surely by stating the obvious, it's an absolutely must win because he's got nowhere to go if he doesn't win.
That's exactly it, Ali. You know, where does he go if he doesn't win? You know, is it about, you know, has he got the appetite to rebuild again? You know, after what he's achieved in the game, you know, being Olympic gold medalist and two-time world heavyweight champion, I think his ultimate goal now and his mission now and what feeds him and, you know, keeps him motivated, really, is the fact that he wants to become a three-time world heavyweight champion. So if he loses here to Ngannou, where does he go? How do you know? It is a massively risky fight, but the rewards are very big because he will get that opportunity again if he comes through.
Spencer, I want to ask you about Ngannou, right? And we've touched on incredible, impressive performance for his first, you know, boxing fight. Now, listen, the question I'm going to ask is, if that's his first, then it would make sense that there's going to still be a massive improvement in him, surely.
Ali, that's a great question, though, because there's a lot of talk about people now saying, well, when Tyson Fury boxed him, Fury was going into the unknown because there was no footage of him, and the footage we did see didn't look particularly good, you know, and you go in there, and so Fury didn't really know what to prepare for. So there was no fear factor there. But for Anthony Joshua, the fear factor is there because he now knows what he's going into. But on the flip side, now, Ngannou's never been in a boxing ring before, so I know sparring and competing is two totally different things. Yep. You know, it's like two different sports. And, you know, you've got the smaller gloves, no head guards and whatnot. And I thought Ngannou adapted very well in that first fight. And what he's going to take from that is he now knows what he's going into. So he will be improved and he will be better. So that will make him a more formidable force. It's a, you know, it's an intriguing one. Like, yeah. I say, it's a tough one. And Joshua, look, I think with the momentum of Anthony Joshua at the moment, if he plays it smart and keeps it safe and takes his opportunity when he has to, you know, he wins the fight. But there's that element of risk there where you go, Ngannou, with the punching power that he's got, I don't know if you see, boys, see him in that punch ball recently. You saw it.
Ridiculous.
The punching power this guy has got. If he hits you, he'll stay hit. So Joshua's got to be very careful.
Intriguing. Spencer, thanks very much indeed.
Enjoy, mate.
Cheers, guys.
On AM, on DAB, via the TalkSport app and on your smart speaker. TalkSport.